discussing the state of NASA, launching supplies to the space station, and more good news for OSIRIS-REx. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. NASA Administrator Bill Nelson made his first State of NASA address to employees on June 2nd from our Mary W. Jackson NASA Headquarters building. His speech touched on agency priorities going forward and included the announcement of two new planetary missions, Veritas and Da Vinci Plus, both targeted for launch between 2028 and 2030.
These two sister missions both aim to understand how Venus became an inferno-like world capable of melting lead at the surface.
He also highlighted our Artemis plans to establish a long-term human and robotic presence on the moon, which
will help develop the experience and capabilities we need to eventually send the first astronauts to Mars.
And he spoke about the new Earth System Observatory missions, which will help us understand and track how climate change is impacting communities across the country and around the world.
We're on track to do so many more amazing things for the country and the world, because that's what NASA does, and no one does it better.
On June 3rd, SpaceX launched a Dragon cargo spacecraft from our Kennedy Space Center, loaded with more than 7,300 pounds of science, research, crew supplies, and hardware for the International Space Station. This is the company's 22nd contracted cargo resupply mission to the station for NASA.
We have a nominal EDM burn, and we're bringing the samples home.
More good news for our OSIRIS-REx team, the May 10th departure maneuver that propelled the spacecraft away from asteroid Bennu was calculated and executed so precisely that a previously anticipated corrective maneuver was not needed. The next possible maneuver adjustment could occur in 2022. The spacecraft is on track to deliver an asteroid sample to Earth on September 24th, 2023. The 2021 Atlantic hurricane season kicked off on June 1st. Our colleagues at NOAA are predicting another active season with an above-average number of named storms. Check out nasa.gov/hurricane to learn more about the work NASA is doing to study storm formation and impacts and ways to better understand Earth as a system. On June 2nd, cosmonauts Oleg Novitsky and Pyotr Dubrov of the Russian space agency Roscosmos conducted a spacewalk to prepare the Pier's docking compartment for removal and disposal. It will be replaced by the new Russian multi-purpose laboratory module named Nauka, which is Russian for science. That module is targeted for launch to the station this summer. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.